morning, everyone. As you walk in, please remember to not leave a gap so that staff can have a seat. And also for Catholics receiving communion, please sit to the aisle. Thank you.
Okay, as we settle down, I invite all staff members to find a seat within the gaps so that we are not standing at the back. I invite all staff members to have a seat so that we are not standing at the back. Okay, can we have everyone to observe a moment of quiet? As we gather in this space that we are very familiar with and has seen us perform our PE, many concerts, but in this time, this space will be used for a space of prayer and reflection in our joint praise. So I invite you just observe a stillness, a moment of stillness to quieten our hearts as we quieten this space into a sacred space.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sola Malisi.
And I'm Erica Nyadu.
We will be your commentators for today. Christmas can be a meaningful and joyous celebration for many of us. Presents, good food, carols, and visiting families can form part of the fabric of some of our personal traditions. We are also mindful that for some of us, Christmas does not hold the same significance. At Seisen, Christmas connects deeply with the Christian belief in the birth of Jesus and what that means for humanity. How might we all find meaning in this time together, whether Christian or not?
In our celebration today, we welcome everyone into the sacred space. The rites and rituals can feel foreign to us, who are not new to the school or whose personal traditions are different from those of Catholics. As the commentators for the Mass today, we hope that we can support all of us in a deeper understanding of this tradition. We ask that at minimum you observe respectfully. We encourage, if you are comfortable, to sing carols with us, pray, and respond as indicated on the screen. Be mindful of your prayerful presence to the person next to you. So let us begin the celebration together by singing our opening song together. Please stand.
Thank you. Jesus, you are the image of the invisible Lord, the firstborn of all creation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, you are God's true child, born of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Jesus, your word made flesh, full of grace and truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, mercy on us. Forgive us our sins to bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us all now be seated and together we will listen to the first reading.
Stories are a big part of many religious traditions. Stories help us to make connections between our lives and the beliefs we hold. Our stories today begin with the prophecy of Jesus being born, a prophecy that was told at a time when people felt alone, abandoned, and oppressed. In many ways, our world today continues to be torn with violence and hurt. Perhaps these readings can help us make sense of how we might respond and relate to God in our lives.
wet enough for you to wear out the patience of people, so do you have to wear out God's patience too? Well then, the Lord himself will give you a sign. A young woman who is pregnant will have a son and will name him Emmanuel, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Typically, after the first reading, there is a response or a song that forms the people's response compared to what they've heard in the reading. This morning, in responding to the prophecy from Isaiah, the prayer chosen is the word spoken by Mary when she had to respond to the angel's message of her bearing God's Son.
The response is, "My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior."
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
My heart exalts in the Lord. My horn is exalted in my God. I have swallowed up my enemies. I rejoice in my victory.
My heart exalts the Lord, my Savior.
The bowels of the mighty are broken, while the tottering gird on strength. The well-fed hire themselves out for bread, while the hungry fatten on spoil. The barren wife bears 7 sons, while the mother of many languishes.
My heart exalts the Lord, my Savior.
The Lord puts to death and gives life. He casts down to the nether world. He raises up again. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He humbles, he also exalts.
My heart exalts the Lord, my Savior.
He raises the needy from the dust. From the dung heap he lifts up the poor, to seat them with nobles and make a glorious throne their heritage.
My heart exalts the Lord, my Savior.
We will now listen to the Gospel, which are stories about Jesus. Usually, Catholics stand for this reading. However, for today, we invite you to remain seated as the birth of Jesus is retold. We are also going to have our friends from kindergarten join us. The Alleluia is often sung as a way of indicating their reverence and a place of honor that the stories about Jesus have in their faith. We invite you to sing along to ready ourselves for the Gospel and to invite our little friends into our sacred space.
Thank you. those days, Caesar Augustus, the emperor of the time, issued a command that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to their town to register.
Roman Empire is getting bigger, expanding! We need to know who is part of the Roman Empire. I want everyone to write their names in this book!
You cannot get everyone to write their names in this one book. That's too many people.
You're right. Let's have many books where people can write their names, and you can collect them all for me later.
What? Okay.
So, Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was promised to be married to him and was expecting a child.
Come on, Mary. Let's go to Bethlehem to register for a census.
Thank you, Joseph. I need some help getting there. I cannot walk to Bethlehem in the States.
Okay, you can ride on this donkey. Let's be quick. I'm worried that there may not be any place for us to stay.
While they're there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
At the same time that this was happening, there were shepherds in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks of sheep at night.
What a silent night it is tonight.
Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Do not be afraid. We bring you good news that brings great joy to all people.
Are you paying attention? We said we have good news.
What good news do you bring? Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He's the Messiah, the Lord.
This will be a sign to you. You'll find the baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all good people.
The angels then left the shepherds. They said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem and see the baby that has been born. We should follow that star."
Did you know that shepherds are considered outcasts of society? Outcasts are people who are excluded. People think that they do not matter. Most people did not trust shepherds and did not want to hang out with them. It is interesting that the message of Jesus' birth first came to them. I wonder why.
As the shepherds made their way to the stable in Bethlehem, they told everyone they met to join them. Some were amazed and began to follow the shepherds. Come and see this baby that has been born. He is said to be the Messiah.
Are you sure that's just an ordinary baby? Leave me alone.
The new king is to be born.
born in Bethlehem, we are going to see him.
Go away, shepherd. You should not be saying things like this.
Hey, some angels told us about this baby. He will be the next king. Come and see.
Really? I want to see. I will follow you.
Yes, me too. I'll join you. As a few people gathered to see and visit the child Jesus, they were greatly surprised by the radiance of Mary and Joseph and the baby. Could a future king really be born in such a poor state? They sang praise and kept watching with the Holy Family. One little boy played his drum quietly.
Excuse me, may I play my drum to honor this special moment?
Yes, I'll be happy if you do so.
Gospel of the Lord.
Please remain seated as our kindergartners take their leave. After this, Father will share a short message to help us connect the stories we have heard to our lives.
When you come to school in the morning and you go into your classrooms, what's the first thing that you have to do? Maybe one of the first things that happens in the classroom. Yes? Do you have a roll call? Do you have a roll call at the beginning of class? Yes. And then when your name is called out, what do you say? Here, here. When I was, long time ago, when I was at school, my roll call, we had to reply, present. That was what we had to say. But children, kindergarten children, are leaving. Okay, they've had enough. Well, we will keep on giving anyway. So, like I said, when I was going to school, our response at the roll call was present. I'm here. Meaning that I'm here and I'm ready and I'm ready to do what needs to be done. We've heard today Jesus' other name being used several times, first in the first song, and also at the first reading. Do you remember what his other name is? It's Emmanuel. That's it. Emmanuel. Very old name. And it means with us. God is present right here in Jesus. So we have this Emmanuel. Jesus means God saved. That's what he does. Emmanuel is talking about who Jesus is. He is God present with us. Jesus said at the very beginning, that is the name that he has been given to explain who he is. God is with us. God is with us. God is present. Emmanuel. And Jesus himself talks about that when he talks to his disciples. He tells them, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am present. I am with you. And at the end too, after Jesus, after the resurrection, he says to his disciples, I will be with you till the end of time. God is present. God is with us. God is caring for us always. So that is the being present. So if we're talking about presence today, what's the theme? Oh, sorry, the theme for our Advent today is being present. So when we think about Christmas time, we think about presents. We think about what's under the tree. We think about what we have to buy our friends and our family members. We're thinking about that kind of present. Because it comes from the same word. Present means to place before someone. To place before someone what is important to them. Something that you show how much you care about them, how much you love them, how much you really want to be there. So that's about being a present. But also, to do that, we've learned very especially during the COVID times, and you had to do everything online, and you talk to your classes online, you had to talk to your grandparents online, talk to your friends and cousins online. That's not quite the same thing as being present there, being right there, and you can actually see them and hear them and talk to them and hug them and say, I'm present, I'm here. I'm with you. It makes so much more to be right there, to be present. So we talk about two presents then at Christmas time. The presents that we get, and they're fun, and it's a nice thing about other people getting them presents, or making them presents, or whatever that we do. That's a lot of fun. But also just being present, being there, being with the people that you love. And that's such a special, special time. And that's why people have to travel long ways away sometimes at Christmas time to be with their family. Who's going to be leaving Japan? Who's going to be leaving Tokyo at Christmas time? Who's traveling overseas? Ooh, lots of you. And there's a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. And then you'll be present with your family and friends overseas. And a very special time. Who's leaving Tokyo over? Who's staying in Japan but leaving Tokyo? Okay, there's another lots of kids all traveling. Sometimes it can be very tiresome and wearying, and long queues and crowded trains and planes, but still we do it. Who's going to be staying in Tokyo for Christmas? Yeah, still, that's fine. We can still be present to the people that we are with right here, right around us. So to be give a present is to give something that you like to feeling or expressing our feelings, our love for others, but just being present is very important. And that's what Jesus is telling us today. His other name is Emmanuel. God is present with us. God is not far away. God is here. And God cares for each one of us. And he shows us in a very special way. Jesus was born as a baby. And without the help of the shepherds, who probably gave him a woolen blanket to keep him warm, without the gifts from the three wise men who came and gave him presents to look after him, because then the family had to, because they needed some help because they were very poor and just living in a stable for that time while he was born. So without the help of others, Jesus, well, we wouldn't know what would have happened. So Jesus, it's a message to us. God is with us, but God need each one of us for Jesus to be alive and present in this world. Without our help, without our reaching out and caring for others, Jesus cannot be present. So that's our special time. So, yes, Christmas is a lovely time to celebrate. God is with us, and then we can be present to those around us, but also God needs us. God needs our hands to do nice things for others. God needs our warm hearts to make others warm and cheerful. God needs us loving and caring for others to bring peace into this world. So that's our special message for today. So let us all now stand as we listen to the prayers of the faithful.
As we come to the end of a semester of learning, we are grateful for the many moments of care and love we have received. We pray for those who have felt lonely, unloved, and forgotten. May they feel the divine embrace today. Lord, in your mercy.
We pause to think about people whose basic needs of food and water remain unmet. May we recognize our blessing and work towards providing for those in need. Lord, in your mercy.
The story of the birth of Jesus reminds us of the power of humble love. May our world, that is torn by violence, neglect, and pride, find healing in those inspired by your call to love humbly. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for all families. May the homes we live in reflect forgiveness, tenderness, and resilience, just like Mary and Joseph. May we never take our families for granted and be loving members of our home. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We make these prayers and those said in the silence of our own hearts, in the name of Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. The second half of the Catholic Mass is where Catholics offer bread and wine as a representation of the work that they do. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands. These rites are meant to prayerfully connect what Catholics do in their daily lives to what is celebrated in this time. For non-Catholics, this part may feel distant from any participation you may offer. At the same time, it is a time rich in symbolism and significance. So perhaps a phrase uttered, a prayer mentioned, or a gesture performed may form the basis of your continued reflection. Feel free to continue singing in the songs.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that these sacrifices may accept the God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, of our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. And so we thank you, God our Father. You made us to live for you and for each other. We can see and speak to one another and become friends if we are present to each other. And we share our joys and sorrows. And so, Father, we gladly thank you for everyone who believes in you, the saints and angels. We rejoice and praise you, singing together. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. Gave a chalice to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and everlasting covenant, which poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. Mystery of faith. God our Father, remember with joy all that Jesus did to save us. His holy sacrifice which he gives as a gift to his church, we remember his death and resurrection. Father in heaven, accept us together with your beloved Son. He willingly died for us, but you raised him to new life. Jesus now lives with you in glory, but he's here among us on earth. One day he will come in glory in his kingdom, be no more suffering, no more tears, no more sadness. Father in heaven, you have called us to receive the body and blood of Christ at this table, be filled with joy of the Holy Spirit. Through the sacrament you will give us strength to please you more and more. Lord our God, remember Francis, our Pope, Tarsicius, our Bishop, and all those who ministered to you. Help all who follow Jesus to work for peace and bring happiness to others. And bring us all at last together, Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, St. Raphael and Maria, and all the angels and saints that live with you to be one with Christ in heaven. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, unity, Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. So together as one family, we pray the words that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your people, of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, according to your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The angels also called Jesus another name. They called him the Prince of Peace. So we pray for peace throughout the world. We are lucky to be living in such a peaceful country. We pray that peace become a reality for all children, for all people, wherever they may be. And we pray at this time for, also we'd like to offer a sign of peace to each other. And being this is our Christmas Mass, let us say Merry Christmas when we do that, okay? Rather than saying the peace of Christ, we'll say Merry Christmas to each other. So, hands together, and then we say together, Merry Christmas, everyone. Exchange the Merry Christmas to each other.
Procession is a ritual performed by Catholics who participate in receiving the Eucharistic bread. For Catholics, the belief is that the presence of the divine dwells truly in this bread. For non-communicants, that is, non-Catholics or younger Catholics who have not reached the age to participate in this rite, you are invited to pray and enjoy the choir singing a rendition of O Come, O Come, Emmanuel with us. Please be seated. stand.
Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly ask you, O Lord, that through taking part in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely things of importance on this earth and to hold firm to the things of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of us in the name of the Father. So like I said, we're talking about Jesus as Emmanuel, God present with us. And we've got to think about how can we be present to each other, not just buying presents, but ourselves being a blessing to those around us, helping out. Our parents are very busy at this time, end of year. I think all of you can help your fathers and your mothers to do things around the house, to give a present of your time, a present of your energy, present of your enthusiasm. So let's all try to be a little bit more present to each other, being really kind and sharing and caring. And we also like to think on Christmas Day, wherever you may be throughout the world, half of you seem to be going around outside of Tokyo, or more than half, wherever you are on Christmas Day, just say, or remember, say, send in your thoughts on that day, okay? You'll be spread all throughout the world, but say a thought, make a thought, say a prayer for Seisen, our special community here in Yoga. Okay, so let us now go and glorify the Lord wherever we may be for Christmas, and may we always be thankful that God is present with us, and that God is blessing us and loving us always. So we glorify the Lord for the way you live, and by the way we live our lives, and by the way we celebrate this holidays. Thanks be to God.
We end with our Seisen prayer. God, help us turn our hearts and minds towards learning to love as we remember that you love us always and forever. Amen.
Thank you for your respectful and active participation in this time of prayer together. We hope that you have a wonderful winter break and a joyful Christmas celebration. After our closing carol, teachers will dismiss us according to our division. It has been an honor to guide you through this time together. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. If I could get people just to sit down just for a few more minutes, please. Before we dismiss everybody by division, I'd just like to echo what Father Leo said about this idea of being grateful, of being thankful. Christmas time around the world, there are many different traditions. Some people celebrate Christmas, but some people do not. But there is that tradition of gift giving. And today we had in this room, in what was converted into a place of prayer, we had some beautiful gifts given to us. I'd like to acknowledge, first of all, the choir and our instrumentalists. Thank you so much for that beautiful music. For all the students who read at Mass today, and also for our sixth grade, who gave a wonderful drama production for us this morning, thank you too. I know Mr. Britton and his team were wandering around taking pictures and videos, so thank to them. It's a lot of work that they do behind the scenes. And also to members of the campus ministry team. So teachers, if you're on the campus ministry team, could you just stand up and give a wave so people know who you are? A huge thank you to you for all the work and the preparation coming up with Christmas. And of course, Father Leo for leading us through the Mass this morning. Thank you very much. So this is a Christmas gift for everybody here. Your Christmas gift from me is today I'm giving you the opportunity, before you leave school today, to say thank you to somebody. It can be somebody in your class, it can be one of your teachers, it can be our wonderful cleaning staff and our maintenance staff, our guards, bus drivers, all those people who basically help us at Saint Sen every single day. So take an opportunity today to say thank you to somebody and have a wonderful Christmas. And before we go, I would like to acknowledge the sisters. The sisters were sitting at the back. So let's say thank you to the sisters. One, two, three. Thank you, sisters. Okay, so if we could get some of the principals to start dismissing the grade levels, I'm not sure who's going to go first, so. Okay, so Mr. Collin is going to take over. All right, thank you.
Okay, the first division that we will invite to leave our sacred space would be our elementary students. So can I have